Over the series of the first three movies, the Alice character developed almost superhuman powers. I mean, this was taken directly from the video game. All of the powers she had were possessed by other characters in the video game as a result of mutation caused by the T-virus. But I felt, you know, once we got to the end of the third film, if we were to make another movie, I felt that Alice really had to lose her powers because she'd almost reached this kind of superhuman point where I just didn't feel scared for her anymore. What 3D is very, very good at is it's an immersive medium. It really helps with sucking the audience into an environment. And for horror, there's nothing better than that. It's fun to work from other people's scripts sometimes, and it's fun to work from your own scripts. I mean, the advantage I find doing a complicated movie like this, because it's not just two guys sitting around a table and talking for most of the film, is the writing of the script is almost like an extended pre-production period for me. So I'm actually, while I'm writing the script, I'm thinking about how I'm going to achieve these images and how these are actually going to be put on screen. For example, on this movie, I was writing a 3D movie. So I was thinking about what the 3D would look like, what would strengthen the 3D effect while I was writing the screenplay. And, you know, if you think that screenplay writing process probably takes 6 to 9 months, that's a lot. There's no director in the world who gets 9 months worth of pre-production before he goes and shoots a film. I get that partly as by being the screenwriter. All the cheats that you usually use in two-dimensional filmmaking don't work anymore. So traditionally, you know, when you kind of block a fight scene and somebody gets punched, you know, you have the hand moves across somebody's face and then the stuntman goes "Ugh," to make it look like he got punched. It doesn't work in 3D, because in 2D you can't tell the distance from the hand to the face. In 3D you know that my hand is a foot away from my face, so that cheat doesn't work. So if you want to see someone punched in the face, you have to punch them in the face. It's a totally fresh Resident Evil movie. And I think even if you've seen the other films, I guarantee you've never seen anything like this film. So I think, and I hope, that it's going to reinvent the Resident Evil franchise and make it brand new again for people.